What's good with ya, baby?
Peace and love. Peace and love to everybody out there, man. Hope all is well. We gotta take care of ourselves, man. Staying safe out there. It's your boy Amaya back to y'all with another reaction. This is gonna be a fun one. This is gonna be a fun one to react to because I've seen a lot of Mayweather fights in my life, but I've never heard of this dude or even seen this fight before. So the reason why I want to review this fight, Floyd Mayweather Jr. versus Emmanuel Gustis, last night, y'all know how y'all go down the YouTube rabbit hole, random videos pop up, you know, recommended, the YouTube rabbit hole. So last night I was down that hole and I came across the Floyd Mayweather interview and someone had asked him, who was your toughest opponent? See, in my head, I'm thinking like he gonna say like Pacquiao, Canelo. Who's the dude back in the day? Damn, it was a big fight. He big boxer that he fought back in the day, like a Mexican boxer. De La Hoya, Oscar De La Hoya. I thought he was gonna say him too. But this is the dude that he said, Emmanuel Augustus. They call him the Drunken Master. Now, I don't know too much about dude. I knew about his nickname, but I never knew that was Emmanuel Augustus, so I don't know too much about dude. But for Floyd Mayweather to say you was his toughest opponent, man, like, subscribe if y'all knew. Listen, this is gonna be a fun one. Let's go. Floyd said that. Y'all can go look it up. Just a video dedication to Emmanuel, who was shot recently. He lost his fight, but he gave one of the best. All my prayers go out to him. I don't know how long ago this was this ago, but my prayers go out to him. That's to.
Hey, Floyd, question. Looking at you as a fighter, yeah. I know you mentioned a few years back that your toughest fight to date was Emmanuel Augustus. I wanted to know, yeah. Do you still consider him your toughest fight to date?
Absolutely. Emmanuel, at that time when I faced him, he was the Emmanuel Burton, but he's Emmanuel Augustus now. And, you know, it's always respect to a man. I always respect the man so for whatever he want to be called. But Emmanuel Augustus was my toughest opponent thus far. And, you know, his record didn't show, his skill set, but the guy was unbelievable.
That's what I heard, too, because I do my little research and whatnot. I heard he didn't have a bad record, but isn't, like, what Floyd's record is, like, undefeated or 41-1, 41-2. But that's crazy, though. When he was like Pretty Boy Floyd, he was like a lot more aggressive than he was when like Floyd Money Mayweather. And he probably was. Like, I think as he got older, his defense started increasing. That's that. Because when I look at his younger fights, he was aggressive as fuck. Like, he was real.
Burton with two left hooks. Burton smiles. Burton will show you. Us yesterday, he feels very comfortable with his own time in jail on a drug possession. And also that all the speculation to me was that he didn't see his father again when he was 21. His father went to prison when he was 16.
So that's why they call him the Drunken Master, because the way his reflexes is, the way he be dodging punches and the way he be clowning other boxers in the ring. Okay. That might be the reason why they call him that.
First round. Unusual thing about Emmanuel Burton is He says he doesn't want change. But he has to change it from half a jab first. I mean, unless he jabs first. Stand there, you know, pull up, flinching, and I'm moving. It's basic. You need to pull out the jab, bring it down. Going wrong. He goes straight back in the lines. Every time. He goes straight back in the line of six. And then the ball is not taking advantage of
it. But he hit it so quick. This is what makes Floyd Mayweather so effective. His speed, one of the quickest fighters in the game.
Definitely, I would say, you know, his reflexes. I mean, he's very young. Hey, he's got quick reflexes. He moves though. Just enough out the way. Look at these punches. I mean, he's not even loading them. He's just throwing, letting his hands go. Very quick, very accurate. Both hands going at the same.
So what is his strategy? Why did Floyd, I know it's a lot of rounds to precede this, but why did Floyd say that was his toughest fight? And what's his strategy? I guess to like tire out his opponent. That's why he's taking a lot of punishment. I don't know. That's a smart strategy though.
Time. I mean, the only thing about Mayweather's doing wrong is his chin here. Suddenly get hit like kind of hard. He's too quick.
We're starting round three. Julie Letterman, how do you have it through two?
He can still stand toe to toe with all the punishment that he taking. Oh yeah, he got a new fan out of me. He got a strong chin, man. He taking them hits and still coming back, still standing toe to toe, being aggressive. Nah, he cold. He cold. I can see why he said.
23-year-old champion Shane Rush. What rush? Mayweather firing off several punches.
Remember
6 months. I didn't know 16 knockdowns twice.
That's how he's in trouble.
Punches, man. Oh no, this dude tough. He tough. This dude tough. See, I can see why he said that, because them shots that Floyd giving to him, a normal like boxer would have been knocked out. I mean, Floyd don't got the strongest hands, but it's so fast though. His jab and his right hook, left foot, this is fast, bro. That can knock any nigga out, but he takes. And he's still being aggressive.
I think that's a bad spot. Only takes a chance.
Mayweather. Now relying on Jackson.
And the referee's got one of your points.
Short, crisp right hand from Floyd Mayweather. He's not scared. He's not scared.
That's why they call him the stroke. That's his strategy. He trying to like anger the opponent to open Floyd up, and Floyd not going for it, because he could have easily would have kept punch going off on him while he was dancing. That's his strategy, which is a smart ass strategy, bro. Taunting an opponent like.
Short, crisp right hands, but Barton comes back, Kevin, with a strong left that opens up Mayweather's nose.
What a big thing I say, the mirror throws a punch, he's his chin right in the air to be hit, and that's exactly how Bird's catching, as you see right there. He throws a punch, instead of ducking behind his shoulder, he uses his chin here, and that's why Burton capitalized.
When you're in with a guy, that blows
him down. Right to the body, early, from round one, you do not allow the speed. You gotta really, you gotta move your head, awful with a punch, a man.
Mayweather more active, though, that many punches.
Bruh, I've never seen Floyd take dial off.
In the middle of the ring, flashes a big smile.
He threw his best shot, but it's still there. I mean, to me, this ain't so far as far as.
I never seen Floyd get opened up like this, bro. I mean, you see occasionally Floyd get hit with like a couple punches in the match that kind of rock him, but he really getting rocked. I guess it's all part of his strategy to like tire Floyd out. I mean, you're not gonna tire Mayweather out, but I think that's the strategy, and it's kind of working a little bit.
Use that right hand.
Yeah, you know, he's landing the right hand over and over again.
it's working for him, so he keeps going by it. But, you know, you just see, you know, as it's saying, the guy had a hard hit.
I thought someone said this ended in a decision or whatnot. That's crazy.
Okay. Pretty boy, Floyd Mayweather Jr.
TKO. Yo. I think, yeah, Floyd obviously won the fight. But had this went to decision, it would have been closer. Even though Floyd was really teeing off on that boy. But I feel like Emmanuel Gustis is probably why the reason why he said that's his toughest opponent. Because he's so, like, with his movements, I can tell by that. I got to watch the whole fight. These are just highlights. I got to watch the whole fight. But the way that he was just moving, it's just so unpredictable. You don't know he's going to throw a jab or he's dodging. That's unpredictable, bro. That's probably why he said that, like, the way he was taunting him, that's probably his whole strategy. I mean, they didn't really work out for him at the end, but, man, that was this dude. Yeah, I gotta react to more videos about this dude. I gotta learn more about him because he unique. I never seen a boxer like him before. Literally, never. He hilarious, too, for the taunting Floyd. But, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this. Like, subscribe if y'all know. Y'all want a part two to this? Y'all let me know in the comments. Peace and love to y'all, man. It's your boy, Mike.